Samsung Galaxy A53 versus Samsung Galaxy A52. Is the Exynos 1280 processor on the Samsung Galaxy A53 better than the Snapdragon 720G processor on the Samsung Galaxy A52? Well, let's find out. For the price, the Samsung Galaxy A53 5G goes for 220,000 Naira or $385 for the 6GB RAM, 128GB internal storage option, while the older Samsung Galaxy A52 4G goes for 180,000 Naira or $315 for the same configuration. Now moving to what each smartphone comes with in the box, Samsung messed up big time. The Samsung Galaxy A53 doesn't come with a TPU case, charger or earphones. All it comes with is a SIM ejector tool, manuals, and a USB Type-C cable. The older model, the Samsung Galaxy A52, well, it comes with a SIM ejector tool, a TPU case, a 15W charger, a USB Type-C cable, and manuals. For a mid-range smartphone to come without the TPU case in the box, well, that's forgivable. I mean, this Samsung Galaxy A53 in this awesome blue color looks beautiful, but for it to come without a charger in the box, well, that's just heartbreaking. I had to buy this original Samsung charger. It's a 25W fast charger for 10,500 Naira or $18, and do you know why? That's because the Samsung Galaxy A53 selects chargers. I tried charging it with my Xiaomi charger, my iPhone charger, my Apple MacBook charger, and it wasn't fast charging. Using one of the 33W fast charger that I have, it charged the Samsung Galaxy A53 in 1 hour 56 minutes, and using the same 33W fast charger on the Samsung Galaxy A52, well, it charged that smartphone in 1 hour 15 minutes. So Samsung removed the charger and made sure only original Samsung chargers have the ability to fast charge their smartphones. Well done, Samsung. Steve Jobs will be proud of you guys. For the build quality, both smartphones have Corning Gorilla Glass 5 at the front. As for the frame and rear, they are made from plastic. For the IP rating, both smartphones are IP67 dust and water resistant smartphones and are resistant to up to 1 meter of water for 30 minutes. For the external features, the Samsung Galaxy A53 and A52 are almost identical, except the Samsung Galaxy A52 has a 3.5mm audio jack, while that's missing on the Samsung Galaxy A53. So for the A53, Samsung took away the charger and now they took away the 3.5mm audio jack. Wow, just wow. For a budget smartphone, I give up. Both smartphones have dual stereo speakers and sound identical. Both smartphones have an optical fingerprint scanner on the display, and the Samsung Galaxy A52 unlocks just a little bit faster than the Samsung Galaxy A52. For the same memory card tray, the Samsung Galaxy A53 is a 5G smartphone and can take two 5G cards or one SIM card and a memory card. The same goes for the Samsung Galaxy A52. Both have a hybrid setup, but the Samsung Galaxy A52, at least this version, is the 4G version. Now moving to the display department, both smartphones have a 6.5-inch Super AMOLED display with a resolution of 1080 by 2400 pixels. The display of the Samsung Galaxy A52 refreshes at 90Hz, while the Samsung Galaxy A53 refreshes at 120Hz. Scrolling on both smartphones is super smooth, and honestly, I couldn't tell them apart. For the touch sampling rate though, the Samsung Galaxy A53 is higher. It refreshes at 240Hz, while the Samsung Galaxy A52 refreshes at 180Hz. For brightness, I got almost the same nits from both smartphones, and consuming media on both smartphones is good. You're not going to have any issues with any of them. Now, pushing the display specs aside, which smartphone has the better display? And for me, they both look identical. The Samsung Galaxy A53 has the higher refresh rate and also the higher touch sampling rate, so in the display department, it wins. Now for the juicy part, the processor. The Samsung Galaxy A52, well, it comes with a Snapdragon 720G processor, while the Samsung Galaxy A53 comes with the Exynos 1280 processor, a 5nm processor. The lower the nanometer, the more efficient the processor is. Now, starting out with running Antutu benchmark, the Samsung Galaxy A53 has the higher number. Moving on to Geekbench, I'm not totally sure if you can trust these numbers because someone was caught cheating. The Samsung Galaxy A53 has the higher single and multi-score numbers. Launching 3D Mark wildlife test to test out the graphic performance of both smartphones, the Samsung Galaxy A53 wins. Moving on to performance test mobile, the Samsung Galaxy A53 wins. And finally, to PC Mark, the Samsung Galaxy A53 wins. Guys, that was a flawless victory. Samsung Galaxy A53 won all the benchmark tests. Now, one area where at the moment the Samsung Galaxy A52 seems better than the Samsung Galaxy A53 is gaming. It looks like the Exynos 1280 chipset hasn't been optimized for your favorite games. For example, Call of Duty Mobile, the Samsung Galaxy A53 played the game at medium graphics and very high frame rates, while the Samsung Galaxy A52 played the game at high graphics and maximum frame rates. frame rate. For PUBG, the Samsung Galaxy A53 played game at HD graphics and high frame rate. The gameplay was decent, no issues. Moving on to the Samsung Galaxy A52, it also played the game at the same graphic settings. Now for a game that brings most smartphones to their knees, Genshin Impact, both smartphones were able to play the game, but the gameplay on the Samsung Galaxy A52 was better. It certainly looks like the Exynos 1280 processor hasn't been optimized for gaming at the moment, but looking at the benchmark numbers, it has more than enough processing power to play those games at higher graphic settings. For the operating system, both smartphones are running Android 12, the Samsung Galaxy A53 is running One UI 4.1, while the Samsung Galaxy A52 is still on One UI 4.0. Both smartphones are smooth as butter, partially thanks to virtual RAM. With the Samsung Galaxy A53, you have the option to extend your RAM by 2, 4 or even 6, while the Samsung Galaxy A52 is set at 4GB and you can't change it. For the performance department, the Samsung Galaxy A53 has the faster processor. Rendering videos is also faster on this smartphone. At the moment, the Exynos 1280 chipset hasn't been optimized yet. It's a new chipset and an update from game makers will solve that problem, so there's no really need to worry about that. Moving to the camera department, both smartphones have a 32MP selfie camera and they take really good pictures. For the skin tone, the Samsung Galaxy A53 does a better job. The details captured by the camera of both smartphones is very good, and honestly, I am happy with the pictures produced by both smartphones. Checking out more pictures from the front-facing camera, again, the skin tone on the Samsung Galaxy A53 is just popping. Sharpness is on par on both smartphones. High dynamic range HDR seems to be better on the Samsung Galaxy A53. For portrait shots, look at this picture, guys. Lord have mercy. Samsung does have the best cameras for budget smartphones. Both smartphones killed it.
What's up, guys? Here's a video from the front-facing camera of both smartphones. I'm using the 32MP front-facing camera, and both smartphones are shooting in 4K 30 frames per second. So which one has the better mic quality? Which one has the better video quality? Which one makes colors pop? Let me know in the comment section below, which one would you prefer? Are you going to pick the video and audio quality coming up from the Samsung Galaxy A52 over the A53? Let me know in the comment section below. It looks like both smartphones are struggling to handle dynamic range. Looking at the viewfinder, I don't know. So guys, which one would you prefer? And the A52 is looking good, as well as the A53. This is going to be hard. Dynamic range, I can see some cloud in the viewfinder of the A53. I can't even see any on the A52. So which one would you prefer? Let me know in the comment section below. But they both look good. As in, this is how a camera should be, man. And just for reference, I've switched the resolution to 1080p 30 frames per second and not 4K. So this is how 1080p footage looks from both smartphones. Looks good as well.
Moving to the rear camera, both smartphones have a 64MP main camera, a 12MP ultra-wide camera, 5MP macro camera, and 5MP depth camera. Now comparing the pictures captured by the main camera of both smartphones, ladies and gentlemen, it's hard to pick a winner. There's a bit of sharpness to the pictures of the Samsung Galaxy A53, but this picture captured by the Samsung Galaxy A52 still looks good. Taking a look at more sample pictures, it's hard to pick a clear winner. The Samsung Galaxy A53 colors look a bit more saturated, which most people would like, and take a look at the sky, it's more vibrant on the Samsung Galaxy A53. Moving to the wide angle camera, the Samsung Galaxy A53 does a better job. The picture captured by the Samsung Galaxy A53 is more vibrant and a little bit more saturated. For 10x digital zoom, details look better on the Samsung Galaxy A53. Now for night photos, lens flares has been reduced on the Samsung Galaxy A53 and the details are a bit better on the Samsung Galaxy A53.
And now we're using the main camera of both smartphones. I'm shooting in 4K 30 frames per second, and which one is doing a better job? Man, look at that blue, the Samsung and saturation. That's not how the blue roof looks like, guys. But it looks good. So in shooting in 4K, let me pick up the pace and see which one has video stabilization. It looks like when you're shooting in 4K, there's no video stabilization. So what do you guys think about the video and audio quality coming out from both smartphones? Shooting in 4K, 30 frames per second. Dynamic range is looking better on the Samsung Galaxy A53. So guys, I'm using the wide angle camera of the A52 and A53. Which one do you prefer? So it looks like the Samsung Galaxy A53 has image stabilization using the wide angle camera. Let me pick up the case. It's doing a better job than the Samsung Galaxy A52. So that's an improvement. Okay, and now I'm shooting in 1080p, 30 frames per second, and pardon me, I'm shooting in 1080p, 30 frames per second, and let's pick up the pace and see which one does a better job in stabilizing the footage. It looks like the Samsung Galaxy A52 did a better job. It looks like. Let me know which one you think did a better job in the comment section below.
So guys, for the camera department, the Samsung Galaxy A53 wins. Now moving to the battery department, the Samsung Galaxy A53 comes with a 5000 mAh battery, while the Samsung Galaxy A52 comes with a 4500 mAh battery. When I was testing out the performance of both smartphones running benchmark tests, the Samsung Galaxy A53 battery drained a bit faster. So even though the Samsung Galaxy A53 has the bigger battery, it seems like you're going to get almost the same screen on time from both smartphones. Now for the charging time, both smartphones are capable of charging at 25 watts. I used a 33 watts fast charger on both smartphones, and I noticed that the Samsung Galaxy A53 selected chargers. It took the Samsung Galaxy A52 1 hour 15 minutes to charge from 0 to 100%, while using the same charger on the Samsung Galaxy A53, well, it took it 1 hour 56 minutes. Like I said earlier, I tried 6 different chargers and the result was the same. I even used the same charger that I used to charge the Samsung Galaxy A52 and it wasn't fast charging. For the charging time, using a 25 watts fast charger made by Samsung, well, you just have to wait for my full review. So guys, the winner of this comparison test is the Samsung Galaxy A53, even though it doesn't come with a TPU case or charger in the box. It's also missing the 3.5mm audio jack. I don't know why Samsung took it out. The major improvement is in the performance department and the camera department, especially for videos. So guys, I will be comparing the Samsung Galaxy A53 with the Redmi Note 11 Pro and also the Redmi Note 10 Pro. So subscribe to my channel if you don't want to miss out on that video. We've come to the end of this video. Thank you for watching guys, and I will see you very soon. Follow reviews, signing out.